I'm Garrett.
And I'm Christy.
We're Big Road Adventure. Today we're here at the Bayou RV Resort, which we've actually been at since November 1st, right?
Yeah.
So 5 months we've spent here. And so we've gotten to know it quite well. This place is pretty nice.
It is.
Now, granted, we're pretty new to this whole thing, so we don't have a lot of points of reference, but just everything about it, as far as the trees and the people and the amenities, and relatively speaking, for the cost even,
yeah,
for Florida, if you do seasonal at least, not bad. And it's been a great place, and we've been very happy to stay here. We had hoped we had traveled more this year, but we just didn't. It's about to start all our travel. But we want to do a video, quick video about the park. One thing we love about the park, there's two sections. There's the original section that we've stayed in for the last few months, and then the newer section. So the original section is really tree oriented, and it has gravel lots, so it's not quite as nice as the newer section, but the trees really make a difference as far as just shade and being cooler and nice, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's a golf cart coming.
And there's a golf cart. There's a lot of golf carts here. Hey! And unfortunately, due to COVID, we really didn't get to hang out with people because that just wasn't our thing in the middle of a 100-year pandemic. But everyone we have met has been super nice.
Oh yeah, it's been a great experience.
I think there's different just levels of parks, and this is definitely one of the better ones.
I agree.
And plus, we've been really close to Clearwater. And if you look at all our other videos, we've done a lot of fun stuff around here. So all that stuff was at furthest away was an hour away. And most of the stuff was like half hour away. So there's just a lot of good stuff here.
So hey, let's take them over by the dock.
Go to the dock?
Yeah, because they have a place you can put kayaks in.
They actually have two docks, right?
Yeah, you can fish on one, but not the other.
Yeah, non-fishing dock. So they call it the Bay Bayou for a reason, because it's kind of surrounded by creeks or bayous. The only downside is the backside is on our bayou, but then 580's right there, so it's kind of loud on the back. But we're staying in the front, so it's not too bad. So our first stop is the fishing pier. And there's only one fishing pier that you're actually allowed to fish. And we didn't actually fish this year. Why didn't we fish this year?
I don't know. I guess we were just too busy.
Too busy to fish. How's that work? It was pretty nice, and I think we're actually gonna get a nice sunset tonight.
I do too.
The only bummer is there's a major road right here, which is good and bad, because since it's a major road, there's a lot of stuff really close by without having to drive far. But you can get gas like 30 seconds away from the front of Bay Bayou. But this fishing pier is also kind of loud. You could probably hear that, but there's the major road behind me. And there's the bayou. So it's beautiful, but loud. So honestly, we have not come down here too often, just a couple of times. But it's still, it's cool.
Yeah, it's really pretty.
Remember, you are in the city.
Yeah.
This is the city. Make no mistake about it. We are very close to a lot of urban stuff. The malls and the shopping and racetrack and all kinds of good stuff.
Oh yeah. I've noticed about this park is when you come in, the newer section has less trees than the old section. So when we first got here, as he mentioned, we were in the newer section, which we're going to show you in a few minutes. So I would recommend, if you come to stay at Bay Bayou, if you want to be more shaded, you would get in the older section where there's beautiful trees and palm trees. The only thing is it gets a lot of stuff up on your roof, but it's worth it if you want to stay cool.
Yeah, we've stayed in both sections. The first section we stayed in for a month, and it was nice. It was a really big pad, very private. It was kind of a corner lot, so we had a lot of spread between our neighbors and then one tree above us, so that gave us a little bit of shade. But honestly, the other side, we were a little worried about it with the rocks and the stones, but we still had a cement pad where the picnic table was. And honestly, the stones didn't really bother me that much. Maybe we tracked a little more dirt than otherwise.
A little bit, but I have my rug, and I'll put the link below. I love my rug.
Yeah, the rug is great.
Got that on Amazon.
I guess my biggest complaint is every time I had to kneel down to get into our basement, the rocks were terrible.
Yeah.
And I never managed to remember to bring a pad or something to sit on. So I would just kind of suffer through it. Live and learn.
Yeah.
Maybe someday.
Yeah.
But the road back here is kind of bad. If you do come stay here, I personally, this is my opinion, but the back row, even though you're on the water, it would be pretty loud. So that's the whole back row right there of RVs. I think the further you are to the front of the RV park, the quieter it is and the better spots. Kind of like the core middle is really good.
Yeah, and especially if you have kayaks, because they do have a kayak launch.
Yeah, on the newer side, they have a way to get onto the bayou.
Yes.
So if you like the kayak, this place would be fantastic.
Yes.
Because you can carry your kayak. You don't have to drive anywhere. You just kayak every single day.
Yeah.
So that is a huge plus for this place. In general, this place is just a good, solid place to stay, especially for a long term. And the community here is amazing.
And I feel very safe. They've got a gate.
Yeah, they got a gate.
Security, 24 hours. It's really nice.
Yeah, we had zero problems. No. We keep ourselves locked up just to be cautious, but
yeah.
We've had absolutely no problem here in a total of 5 months.
Yeah.
And they like bands here also. So.
Oh yeah, on the weekends. They either have a barbecue and band, or they do their bingo or their boosie ball, and they have shuffleboard tournaments.
Now, how many bands did we see? Probably
at least 10 while we've been here. Yeah.
And even when it's like really cold out, they're still rolling the bands. They like the party for sure.
They do. So this is where you can put your kayak in if you have that, or a canoe, or I guess a small boat.
Any small boat.
Any small boat.
It's not much to look at, but it'll work.
That's it. Thank you.
nice amenity is the heated pool, which we actually didn't use super much.
No.
Christy went a few times, but it's nice.
Because we went to the beach more.
They have a section that's not heated, but it does have, or it's heated, but not like a hot tub, but it has jets like
it
a
does.
Hot tub.
And it's relaxing. I did sit over there a little bit too.
Yeah, and the clubhouse is nice.
Yeah.
They play a lot of games in there.
Yeah.
And the mail room, mail is free, mm-hmm. which is a nice feature. And we got probably the 2 packages a day.
Yeah. And what they ask is you just put your flight number and they have a mailbox for you and you can check it daily. They'll put a sign out on the door that says the mail is in. So you know that the UPS truck or the FedEx or post office or whomever sent you a package has been by for the day and they sort it.
Is this our room?
And yes, it is.
I can't even remember.
So we're just walking our last day at Bay Bayou.
Yeah, we've had probably at least 200 deliveries since we've been here.
Well, out of
probably more than
months.
That, right?
It's, I don't know.
So we've been here 20 weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say 5 a week. Yeah, at least 100.
At least, yeah.
Easily 100.
Yeah. I don't know, we're putting all of it, but.
Yeah, we live in an RV and we had 100 deliveries. So
that's crazy. Well, some was Christmas presents and others.
Something like this. Yeah. This, like, this was a delivery.
We did get the Magnachets. We're gonna do a video on that.
Oh yeah,
install that.
Those are cool.
Oh yeah.
Good sunsets.
Yes. Yeah, somebody's grilling and it smells really good.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
we just made
chili.
I know.
I so want to eat.
Me too. But we gotta do this.
We're off the wagon for at least a week.
Yeah, we are.
Could eat chili, had steak, had salmon.
And Pizza Friday.
Yeah. Quite the workout.
And we took the gym off this week because we knew we'd be too busy and getting ready to move. And I'm glad we did. We did grocery shop today so we would have food. Although when we get to Creek Fire, I know there's a Walmart down the street. There's a Walmart everywhere. So we can do some grocery shopping.
There's a Walmart everywhere.
There is on every corner. No. But
the big question is, are we going to stay at the Walmart?
I know. I don't know. We'll have to figure that out before we leave.
Walmart, Cabela's. I want to do Cabela's. I think there's.
I do too.
Cracker Barrel will be fun, but.
Yeah, we've done that once.
That's a lot of food.
Yeah, it's either Cabela's or Bass Pro Shops, but let's check that out.
Bass Pro Shops would work too.
Yeah, let's try. Let's check that out.
I need any fishing gear.
No.
Oh, look at that sky tonight.
I don't know. We might find a kayak. Do they sell kayaks? Because I want a kayak.
I think the sky is pretty cool tonight. What do you think?
It is.
It turned out good.
Yeah.
Much better than I thought. Wow, much better.
I know.
I'm going to get a video of this. Here, you hold the stick.
Okay. Garrett's going to do his thing. He's got to get us a sunset pic.